Hello kids, good morning all. Today we will see the question and answers from our chapter number 4, key elements of a democratic government. This is from political science. So let us see question number 1. How would Maya's life be different in South Africa today? So answer is, if Maya lived in South Africa today, she will enjoy equal rights to participate in the affairs of the government. She will have equal benefits and she will be protected by law. No injustice will be done to her. Now, question number 2. What are the various ways in which people participate in the process of government? So the answer is, the people in a democracy participate in the process of government in the following ways. Number 1, the people elect their leaders by voting in the elections who represent them. They take decisions on behalf of the people. Number 2, besides voting, people participate by taking an interest in the morning of the government and criticizing it when required. Number 3, there are ways in which people express their views and make government understand what actions they should take. These includes dharnas, rallies, signature campaigns. Things that are unjust and unfair are also brought forward. Number 4, newspapers, magazines, TV also play a role in discussing government issues and responsibilities. Number 5, people organize themselves in social groups that seek to challenge the government and its functioning. Members of unprivileged groups like Dalits, Advaises, women and others participate in this manner. Now question number 3. Why do you think we need the government to find solutions to many disputes or conflicts? So answer is, conflicts appear when people of different cultures, religions, regions of economic backgrounds do not get along with each other or when they feel are being discriminated against. People may use violent means to settle their differences. This leads to fear and tension among them. The government is responsible for helping to resolve conflicts in a peaceful manner. Now, question number 4. What actions does the government take to ensure that all people are treated equally? The answer is, one of the important principles of democracy is equality and justice. Equality and justice are inseparable. They go hand in hand. Our constitution provides fundamental rights, and one of them is rights to equality, and according to it, untouchability is banned by law. The government makes special provisions for the underprivileged people. The government takes steps to provide justice by providing special, for example, the girl child suffer injustice at the hands of the parents and society. In order to overcome this injustice, fees of the girl in the school may be waived or lowered in government schools or colleges. Now, our last question. Read through the chapter and discuss some of the key ideas of a democratic government. Make a list. For example, all people are equal. So the answer is, the key ideas of a democratic government are following. Number 1, right of the people to vote in the elections. Number 2, re-election of the government after a fixed period. Number 3, the people carry out campaigns and rallies. Number 4, responsible government. Number 5, justice and equality to all. So this is all about our chapter. We will see in next video.